Hey everyone, this is just a quick short little video. I wanted to go over some of the graphics settings that I use in Lotro. So this I find helps for me to crash as rarely as possible in some of the newer regions in Lotro, such as Minas Tirith, Osgiliath, and whatever new regions or instances there might be, like the Pelagor instances. So what I do, even though my machine can handle like the ultra high kind of settings, those newer areas, I guess it's because Lotro is such an old game, there might be poor coding, I don't know, but I will crash the desktop. And I've told some of my friends the settings that I use and it has helped them out, so hopefully it helps you guys out. The settings on the graphics tab here, not too important. I do use DirectX 11. You could use whichever one you want, it doesn't really matter. I'm not using a lot of the DirectX 11 features anyway, because I have a lot of them disabled. So PVMP performance override, I mean, if you're in the Moors, you can leave that checked. Anti-aliasing, I have that set at 2x. I put the ambient light, and this is not going to affect the game stability, but I put this to 1 just to get a little bit more lighting in the game. I find the game overall can be a bit dark, so I like to put the ambient light all the way up. I don't adjust the brightness or the contrast or the gamma level. On the advanced graphics, I do like to have the scenery kind of, or the landscape, render in at more than, you know, just like 20 or 30 feet in front of me. I like to actually be able to see it look good rather than all pixelated. So I do put that at ultra high. The model detail, I have it high. Material detail, high. Landscape draw distance, I have that at very high. Frill distance, very high. Some people don't even care about the frill distance. I mean, that's really just a personal preference to whomever. If you want, you can put that to low, disable it, whatever. Distant impostures, I put a check mark for that. Atmospheric detail, I put that to high. DirectX 11 interactive water, you can honestly disable that if you like. I love the look of the water, I keep that on high. Pretty much a lot of the settings I have on high, but texture detail, high. Texture filtering, I have on tri-linear. And going down here, lighting and shadows really affects the performance, I find, which I think may be the largest contributing factors towards the game crashing to the client. So for lighting, I disable high quality lighting. And I disable DirectX 10 distant light landscape lighting. Under shadows, I disable landscape shadows. I disable blob shadows. I disable stencil shadows. As you can see, I disable everything related to shadows here, so disable it all. Post-processing. Again, these ones seem to have a fair amount of effect on the performance, which I find that anything that seems to have an effect on performance seems more likely to get you to crash the desktop when you're in some of these newer regions. So post-processing effects, I disable. Volumetric sunlight, which is a huge one, I disable that one as well. Scrolling down to performance, I place a check mark and place player mesh combining. I disable avatar texture compositing, and I place a check mark in 3D object portraits. That's up to you. You can see what happens when I enable disable that. I like to have my portrait there. A lot of the times when I'm playing, I just see the back of my head, so it is nice once in a while to just see the front as well. Texture cache size, this is largely dependent on the video card that you have. So I have a powerful video card, so I put that all the way up to the top. You could leave it at the halfway setting if you like. Same with player crowd quality. I put that up to the highest setting, but if you like, you could put that to the halfway mark or to your preference. Refresh rate, I just put this up to what my LCD monitors are, which is 60 hertz. And leave sync to refresh rate, I leave that unchecked. If you check that, then in this case I would only get 60 hertz maximum frame rate. But if I leave it unchecked, then I will get higher frame rates depending on the region or area that I'm in, or, you know, the location that I'm looking at. So, I mean, if I'm looking up at a black sky, I'm going to get really high frame rates. If I'm looking down at the bridge, probably reasonably high frame rates. Looking towards the landscape, they do lower a little bit. Triple buffering is up to you. I have had this enabled in the past, and I'm trying to have it disabled right now to see what kind of effect that'll have on stability. But those are the primary settings that I use, so I do hope that helps you. And yeah, Zonflux out, and I'll catch you on the flip side.